После работы выпьем, а?
Давай.
Ваши билеты?
Of course. Have them right here.
Доброго пути.
Relax, doctor. We're safe now. Just sit back and enjoy the ride.
John, I can't thank you enough for getting me out of there. I used to think I was serving my country by helping the Bioprepara. But I realize now that nothing good can come of their experiments. The best way for me to help my people is to make sure the world knows what's happening there. We need to put a stop to this.
I'm sure it was a difficult decision to make, but you're doing the right thing.
The right thing? If only it were that simple. To my country, I am a traitor. I'll never be able to set foot on my home soil again. My home, my friends, gone. But I'm not a traitor, right?
Doctor, you really shouldn't.
Oh, don't mind my ramblings, John. I'll be fine. I only wish my former comrades would realize the consequences of what they're doing. Most of them don't even understand the destructive potential of the weapons they're creating. Millions of men, women, and children could die at the press of a button. How can you win a war that no one survives? How can you win a war at all, for that matter? Those men are greedy and selfish, willing to sell their knowledge and experience to the highest bidder. Don't they realize? No, I don't suppose they do. Which is why I had to escape.
With your help, Doctor, a lot of lives can be saved.
Exactly. Many lives. There are terrorist groups all over the world that would kill for the information in my head. What if these bioweapons fall into the wrong hands? No one would be safe. I couldn't live with myself if I allowed that to happen. I'm going to tell your people everything I know. Names, dates, places, everything. I can only hope they can come up with a way to stop these experiments or develop countermeasures against them.
We can, and we will.
Do you remember the outbreak in Sverdlovsk in 1979?
Vaguely. I seem to recall.
68 people died along with hundreds of animals. Their blood is on my hands. We were developing an extremely deadly combination of 4 strains of anthrax in a nearby weapons lab in the Urals. Our safety protocols were compromised, and there was nothing we could do to stop it. I was lucky to escape with my life. The government called it a natural infection carried by the animals. I can assure you there was nothing natural about it. We were fortunate to contain it before it spread any further. I should have realized then the horror I was unleashing. You know, I can still hear the screams. I still hear the screams. God help me, John. What have I done?
Assignment that suited to my talents. Whatever it is, it must be pretty important. I have an appointment to meet the shop's director and the assistant director this afternoon at their main office in Texas. They have armories and operations all over the world, disguised as legitimate businesses, like Goldberg's used books. The shop is dedicated to the preservation of peaceful society and a staunch enemy of terrorism. While they know no allegiance to any government, they hire themselves out to countries that have need of their unique services. Some would say they're in the business of solving problems. The kind of problems that just don't seem to go away. I'll be interested to see what they have for me this time.
The director is expecting you, Mr. Mullins. Check in with security at the front desk. They'll issue you a security pass.
Job in Germany. Director Aaron Wilson, and this is the shop's director, Anthony Michaels.
Mr. Wilson, Mr. Michaels.
You can call me Tony. I believe you've already met Dr. Pyotr Ivanovich.
Doctor, it's been a long time.
Indeed it has. 10 years, I believe. I've been working with the shop for some time. Surprising how paths haven't crossed before now.
Now that we're all acquainted. Are you aware of the upcoming World Trade meeting in Switzerland, John?
Yes, of course. Diplomats are flying in from all over the world.
Exactly. And the perfect target for a terrorist attack. The shop is on high alert. We want to be ready for anything.
Where do I fit in?
We have reason to believe my old protege, Dmitry Sestrogor, is developing a new wave of biochemical weapons. Your experience and success in these matters makes you the perfect man for the job.
There was an incident in northern Colombia recently.
An incident?
Doctor, please explain.
Apparently a rebel faction is using viral weapons on civilians to coerce the Colombian government into making concessions to their cause. We want you to go down there and investigate. You need to find out who's behind these attacks, and more importantly, where they're getting these bioweapons. All signs point to Sestrogor, though we can't prove it yet. The Biopreparat as an organization has been dormant for the most part over the past 10 years, but weapons developed by Dr. Sestrogor have been linked to terrorist activities around the world. This man is extremely dangerous, and we need to know if he's involved.
What are the specifics of the operation? Do you have reason to believe these Colombian rebels have interest in the World Trade meeting?
Sorry, John. You're on a need-to-know basis. We want you to fly down there and check it out. Upon successful insertion, our agents will brief you in the field.
I'm getting tired of all this secrecy. Either you people trust me or you don't. If you don't trust me, pay me my kill fee and I'm out of here.
Easy, John. If our security protocols are violated, your mission could be jeopardized. You don't want to risk that, do you? The shop is in the business of secrecy. It's what's kept us going all these years, and it's helped keep you alive. If you're not interested, we can always find someone else.
That will be necessary. When do I leave?
Immediately. There's a chopper outside waiting to take you to the Nimitz.
Taylor, I'll see you soon.
Be careful, John.